Mercedes-Benz understood very well that we needed that release, and what they sent us makes this road trip unforgettable on many levels.
And you see, this is quite literally a brand new car. I kid you not. I picked it up from the showroom with just about 100 kilometers on the odo. And right now it's then about 243. So you see, it is a brand new car. Always a good feeling. Just that at this hour, it's gonna wake up a lot of neighbors. So before I get yelled at, let's get out of here. Ah, it still has that new car smell to it. Smell in a GTR. What more do you want? A perfect start. But the only way to get rid of this is... Wake up the neighbors and run away! What childish joy in doing these kind of things, right? But we just don't grow up. With toys like these, we just don't grow up. That's rain. Ah, come on.
Apparently, I'm the first one for today's drive. It's 5:30, we're about an hour late. But let's hope we can make it in time.
The best part about leaving early in the morning, no one's watching. Roundabouts, no one watching. What more do you want? I can already see how all this is shaping up. We all want that release. We all want this road trip, which is exactly what we're going to do. I'm not doing this alone. I'm going and picking up my colleagues, and then we should continue with this trip. First stop, Anish Sheikh.
And it looks like we've got one more car coming in. That looks like Simran. Usually, he's the last one to arrive. He's still late. But there's still one more car to go.
Not just the sanitizer, but also the mask. Important. I wonder now if the cops catch us and ask us, ek banda aage baithna chahiye, the other guy should sit behind. What do we tell them? No, so this was a genuine problem. So yesterday I applied for the e-pass, right? So on the e-pass, it makes you select the vehicle type.
Yeah, right. There's no
two-seater.
Sorry. For a change, you're not the last one.
First one, yeah.
No, he's not. I mean, well, there you have it.
Well, my streak is over and you finally know who shows up for shoots when. Surprising, isn't it? Something even more special than us.
You guys are gonna be super happy with this.
He brought a tracker for a road trip.
Oh, okay. So these have also got GTRs, huh?
No, that's a GT 4-door. And that's a C63 coupe. That has to be bought. That has to be bought.
And what I mistook for another GTR was actually the GT 4-door, the most powerful AMG that you can take grand touring.
So all of us have made calls to Mercedes-Benz, huh?
Well, we did, but tell me, what made you bring a track car for a road trip?
See, when I made the call, they told me nothing else was available. I told them I have to go road tripping, give me the best you have. So there you have it, that's the best. Grand Tourer also, right? GT.
But is that the GT or is that the R?
No, no. Don't let the color fool you. This is the GTR in GT color.
Wait. Have you gone over any speed breakers lately?
So as I was saying before, let me tell you what we're doing.
No, wait. Let me tell you what we're doing. I've done this before. This is a 500 kilometer long road trip for good food. I've done this before in slightly slower cars. I know we need fast cars, which is why these three. But we're also going to come back today. So it's going to be a mad dash to Balasinor and then back.
Very helpful slippery mode for these times.
Sorry, I'm gonna shift to that.
No chance.
Come on, guys, drive like real men. What slippery mode?
Watch what you say.
Real men take speed breakers sideways, right?
Hey, come on, enough of the speed breaker jokes already, okay?
I just can't wait till we get to the next toll booth.
Let's cross those speed breakers before these guys come in again, make jokes about my car on the speed breaker. I can already hear some chatter on the radio. I'm sure they are joking about the speed breakers. So let's not give them that sight.
So we're up at the first toll and it's given me a chance to really appreciate the backside of Rohit's track car. May not be the wisest choice for this trip, but man, it looks so good.
Hey, photo liya to mere ko bhi 200 diya. Gaadi ka photo liya to mere ko bhi 200 diya.
A car like this, a GTR especially, is a rare sight.
And a sight for sore eyes. This may not be the prettiest example of what grand touring looks like, but three AMGs tripping together is a beautiful sight, no matter what the setting.
The only thing annoying with this is that constant beep that you get about 120 kilometers an hour. It also drowns the infotainment audio, but no infotainment running here. If
because the audio that I want to listen to right now, at least for most part of this road trip, is that growl, the V8 growl. Of course, it's most enjoyable on the racetrack, but then again on the racetrack, you are very focused at the next apex, getting the right line, all of that. On the road, you can nicely relax, enjoy the drive, and let that beautiful sound, the beautiful growl of the V8 fill into the cabin. Take in those sounds. The song of the V8s and the dance of these cars on the slippery, wet and rutted roads felt great. But soon the smooth tarmac disappeared and the highway looked nothing like what we remembered of it.
Potholes scarred. I thought roads would be in a better condition than this, but unfortunately they aren't. This is like playing a video game. But this is where my choice seems to be the right one, because I've technically got the most ground clearance. I've got the most comfortable ride quality. The C63 is a far more comfortable car to drive than the GT63 or the GTR. The GT63, well, it's got a little more comfort than the GTR, and Rohit may have lost some weight, and I'm sure that's now hurting him sitting in the GTR, going over all those potholes, all those diversions, those scarred roads. Something's got to hurt me.
I hope you have an appointment with your dentist at noon.
Again, it's not that bad, it's not that bad. You know, I'm okay with this. I'm just about okay with this. So the potholes are actually quite bad, but not so bad for this car. I mean, you can hear me clearly. My voice is loud and clear when I'm talking to you. Yeah, I mean, okay, it's not that comfortable, I agree. But at least right now it's not scraping anywhere. I'm somehow able to just carefully wade my way through this.
And it's exactly these kind of situations where the GT four-door stands out because it's got a lift function, something that none of them have, which makes it just a lot more peaceful to drive on roads where you think ground clearance might be an issue.
Driving in the gingerly fashion meant that reaching Balasanor in time for lunch was looking far too optimistic now.
Hungry now for power. Now stay hungry the rest of the day as well.
DT of Albert, 188 left.
We're behind time. If we had to leave on time, we'd have made it in time for lunch. But Balasanor is still about 3 hours away. It's almost noon. And while I know they won't serve us cold food, I'm sure it's going to be a lot nicer if you had it piping hot and fresh off the stove.
While we were craving for the food, the AMG V8s were guzzling through all the fuel they got, and well, the heroic GTR was undoubtedly the thirstiest.
Yeah, I have the least range, but I'm having the most fun.
Rohit, for all of his posturing, well, he's had the least range on his car. He ran out of fuel almost 200 kilometers before everyone else. We should have just left him behind at the pump.
With their mighty V8s, these cars go from 0 to 100 in less than 4 seconds. But on roads like these, they take even lesser time to go from full fat to full flat. So he had to be cautious. While we were fueling up, we noticed that the GT 4-door had developed sidewall bulges on both its front tyres. So that was the first casualty of this trip.
Our pace has been slow. We brought these phenomenal cars, all AMGs, so much of horsepower out on the road. But it's all to naught You know, I actually thought Rohit would have a harder time in the GTR. But he's right there. He's always been in my rear view mirror. If not leading this drive, we've still got some distance to go. I'm just now fingers crossed that I'm not the last one to reach there. If you've got something with a C63 and you ever decide to get out on a road trip, there are a few things that you need to keep in mind. One is make sure you've got a fresh set of tires. Also keep in mind that the ground clearance, this is very, very low. So effectively plan your trip. Make sure that you're not going to be driving over some large speed breakers or into areas and regions where that ground clearance could be an issue. Also keep in mind that the suspension is very stiffly sprung, so the ride is fairly hard. Now the C63 also rides on 255, 35 profile tires, so that adds to that harder ride quality. And over a long distance, bad roads, it can be exhausting.
Within moments of saying this, the second casualty struck us. Earth went over a pothole that would never seem harmful to any motorist, but it notoriously slid the sidewall of one of the C63's tires, and that was the end of its life. Sure, the monoblock AMG wheels look great, but on newer AMGs, you usually see this design on the Space Saver wheel. And with that slapped on Bert's car, our journey slowed down further. With about 60 kilometers still to go, lunch plans looked like they would include dinner too. With our tummies growling, we mapped the shortest route possible, and somehow it felt like Google Maps opened the doorway to heaven. What it brought us to was an untouched, smooth back road full of winding turns and no intrusions of any kind. Blame it on the stomachs that were hungry since morning or the souls of us petrolheads that were hungry for months. We had to have a go at these roads, in these cars, no matter what the tires said. And we did.
I'm having an absolute blast in the C63. I can't express just how amazing this car is. It's quick when you want it to be quick, it's powerful, it sounds the best of all of them. Perhaps the GTR may be a little nicer to listen to, but I've enjoyed the C63 thoroughly. It's just so dynamic, so nimble. On these B roads, some of them with really, really tight corners, but fantastically great. It's so easy to drive through those. Confident, precise, even on the motorways. I've been flirting with traffic throughout. And the C63 hasn't had a single complaint. The amount of data that's visible on that screen, especially in that track mode, is phenomenal. You can set up a host of performance modes, but the telemetry, that is just incredible. You can select the most ridiculous amount of information. I mean, things you'd never use. But then you get onto a highway, you go flat out, and all that information is being displayed right there. Linear acceleration, lateral acceleration, steering angle, engine torque, engine power. It even shows you temperature for all wheels, consumption. I mean, it's just insane. Slip angles and whatnot. This thing is just ridiculous. It's a lot of fun. Out on the highways, you can actually do all of this, at least a lot of it, because lateral acceleration, you're not going to be able to see the G's as you're going around a corner, unless you come to a back road, a country road like we are on right now, where you can push this car a little hard around corners, of course, provided you are safe. And then, well, get all that data right there. All three cars have got this level of information in them, the GT63S or even the GTR for that matter. All of them have got this information. Just makes it very interesting to see what each car is capable of achieving.
Sure seems to be the decade of the twin turbo V8 engine, and AMG's engine has something a little special to help it stand out amongst the crop of all these performance twin turbo V8s around. And that little something is the one man, one engine philosophy. Each engine is handmade by an engineer at Afalto Back. Here's a little bit of trivia for you. Each one takes about 4 to 5 hours to assemble. It has about 600 moving parts. And like we've seen in these three cars, go from horsepower around 470, 474 to the most powerful iteration in the car that I'm driving, the 639 PS AMG GT63S 4-door. Called the M177, they've been able to push power to the max in this car with low friction bearings for the turbo that let it spool up a little quicker, stay a little cooler, and they've actually managed to extract every last bit of power out of this engine, which means that I'm still about 50 odd PS over the GTR through its fancy tracker and over 100 above Bird C63.
The C63 that I'm driving, of course, it's the least powerful amongst this trio of cars that we've got. The GT63 being the most powerful, 639 horsepower with 900 Newton meters of torque. I mean, that is an enormous power rating compared to the 400 odd horsepower that I got in the C63. But the power to weight ratio, this is a lot lighter than the GT63, and that gives it incredible performance. The GTR, well, that's in a league of its own. Carbon fiber, aluminium frames. That car is not just light, 500 and 50 horsepower nearly. It's quick, it's fast. The one thing that I'm most envious about Rohit driving that car is that he's come through all of this. Good roads, bad roads, highways, B roads. Very comfortable.
GTR is indeed the very best that AMG has to offer. It may not have the power of the GT 4-door, but it delivers its power in a manner that makes you grin, yell, and soil your pants all in the same breath. Its electronics can make a driving god out of a noob, whether you're driving on the track or on winding roads like these. Then there is the cabin, which has the tastiest material choices crafted to make this space feel premium, sporty and functional. Oh, I could go on and on about it. In fact, we can go on and on about the cars that each one of us drove in, and we actually did, forgetting that we had a lunch, well, dinner, to get to. By the time we got to Balasanor, the whole town was following our AMGs. The cars posed for them, gave them the crackles and the pops. The GTR even lifted one wheel to show off some acrobatics. Despite all the mishaps that we went through with the tires, as we entered the Garden Palace, there was a sense of occasion to this place. Only to be bettered by the palatial dinner spread hosted by His Highness Nawab Sultan Salahuddin Babi and Her Highness Begum Zeba Sultan Khan, who are dear friends of Overdrive.
That's Shami Kebab e Balasanor. The speciality of it is again the filling. Once you taste it, you will come to know what exactly is in that. So that's how.
I remember that from last time.
Okay.
It's
and now this is Nimbu Masala Murk. That's again authentic Balasanori dish, which is again with lot of dry fruits and lot of fresh spices ground. We don't use those normal market spices, we ground them here.
Okay.
So that's again special. That's sukha gosh, and it's also a shikari kind of gosh. So when in olden times when we used to go for shikar, of course not now, but those times, then the masalas which we have used now, it's of those times.
a spread of secret bespoke recipes that have been handed down from generation to generation. A befitting end to a lovely road trip then, and a great way to unlock. Here's hoping that 2021 would be even better.